ngāti hei mōri ora. Tuatahi, he tuku honre ki te matua tamo wairua tapu. Ko ia te kaihanga o ngā me kato, tu pūtake o te ora kato, ko te māngai hei tautoko mai, ākene ai. In translation, first, I offer prayers and honour the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Creator of all things that do exist and the Author of all life, now and forevermore. Amen. Kei te hui hui tātou, i runga i tēnei moutere te waka auraki, te waka Māui me tau vai pōnu, kei raru i te maru o ngā tiri tiri o te mōna ki te hauru, i runga i ngā Pākihi pakateketeke o Waitaha, ku maunga tere ki te raki ngā kohatu whakarakaraka o tamate pōkai whenua, atu ki te tai o māhu nui. Nō reira, koutou e rauranga tira mā. Koutou ngā me, ngā reo, ngā mana huri nō te au. Koutou o Nui Treni me te mā kāinga. Nau mai haere mai ki tēnei rā whakamaumahara. Nō reira, he mihi atu ki a koutou mō tēnei rā i tēnei wāhi tinuata āhua. In translation, we are gathered here upon this, and my reference has been to the beauty of our environment. On this, our island, called the canoe of Auraki, that comes from the heavens, the canoe of Māui, which indicates when we first occupied this island, a deity of ours, and the Greenstone Isle. And greetings to all of the kaihautū, kaihoi, the dignitaries and the speakers from the four corners of the world. Koutou ngā pau o te hahi and to our pillars of the various churches, the speakers of the Christchurch City Council, the voice and the speakers of Parliament, and to those huri nō o te au, welcome into this environment on this day of a memorial day for those who have passed beyond the veil. And today, expressing it in my language, you can see the beauty when I look out from here of all those things associated with the memorial service, because translated, this island and this area is basically a reflection of bringing together Tāne and Tangaroa, the oceans and the fruits of Mother Earth. And so our history and our past is a reflection on all those things because they bind everything together. And so here we are in such a beautiful environment for this Memorial Day. Nō reira, ka piti hono tātai hono, te hunga mate ki te hunga mate, te hunga ora ki te hunga ora. And as well part of our culture, those few words actually depict what we are gathered here for today, because our culture always pays tribute to those of our ancestors who have passed away, and the living, because they go together. It is the heart of our genealogy, of our whakapapa trees that are surrounding you. Just with those words, it reflects all of those things as to why you are here. Ka piti hono tātai hunga, te hunga mate ki te hunga mate, te hunga ora, ki te hunga ora. And so you have on that tree the reminder of the trunk of the ancestors and the beauties attached, the living to that tree and all these trees is you and I. Those of us, the living, are the source of development, of making things happen. Now, I've said that in the past. Tātou te hōra me whakatō ngā purapura hei whakapari here, which means I've always focused and I always will focus on the living because it's the living that will give effect to all those dreams and the wishes of the ancestors. And so as a future event and as a memorial, it does make sense that the focus is now on the rebuild of the city of Christchurch. And it has to be relevant to building a city for people. And the memorial service and those who were killed and died during that experience is a reflection of what the future should be. Now, behind me, there's going to be a lot of big timber coming up, so I'm sort of opening the door because I think we're all on the same page when we're talking about the rebuild and the people who will be resident in Christchurch. So on that note, thank you very much and welcome, thrice welcome. Kei a koutou te pēne o the Salvation Army, na haudamana. That is in translation, we now play the national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand? Please be seated. Today we have gathered to mark the passing of another year since the February earthquakes of 2011. To remember the 185 people who lost their lives or who were seriously injured that day, and to support all whose lives were changed utterly in those brief seconds. The Canterbury earthquakes have left very few in New Zealand untouched. All around our nation today, people will pause in solidarity with us to remember and to grieve. We carry with us today the prayers and the thoughts and the hopes of the whole nation. We also carry the burden of grief for those many families from all across the world who found that they had lost loved ones in a foreign city so very far away. For those who are with us, for those with us in spirit, and for those joining us from far away, we remember. So we gather today to support those whose grief will never fade, to share their pain in the hope that somehow it might be lessened. We gather to remember. Prayer is a way of acknowledging the mystery and the frailty of human life. We try to put into words so hesitantly what is beyond naming. The words of this prayer come out of the Christian spiritual tradition, but we hope you can let them speak for you, whatever your faith may be or none. They're simply an attempt to speak of loss and pain and hope that is absolutely real and sometimes very hard to grasp. So let us pray. Spirit of life, who holds all people together, we cry out for courage and for comfort in our grief. We bring to this memorial our feelings of loss and pain. We bring too our memories of good times, of love and laughter. We come in the belief that grief does not have the final word, that love is immortal, that death is only the horizon, and the horizon is nothing but the limit of our sight. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Tēnā mana, nā reo, nā iwi, tēnā koutou, tēnā rātātou, katoa. I wish to begin by acknowledging all who have gathered here or who have tuned into the broadcast today to grieve for a loved one who died on February the 22nd, 2011, or who were seriously injured on that day, or were traumatised by what they saw or what they were called upon to do, or who have experienced loss as a result of the earthquake. And in this I include people who lost their homes, their neighbourhoods, their businesses, their jobs. We have been through a lot as a city, and there is still much healing to be done. That is why I wanted this commemoration to be away from the scenes of devastation that haunt our city. I wanted us to be surrounded by beauty. I wanted to hear the chime of the world peace bell because it is so meaningful in light of what has occurred. The original world peace bell was gifted to the United Nations in 1954 by a Japanese mayor. Gifted 50 years later to Christchurch, our peace bell, like the original, is cast from the coins of the nations that make up the UN. So it's sounding today will remind us of all the nationalities who have experienced loss in our city. There is a piece of Panamu that sits beneath the peace bell that has a matching piece buried beneath the peace sculpture in Nagasaki Peace Park. I believe that today the chiming of this bell will resonate in Japan. When a city experiences a traumatic event, people respond and recover in different ways. The gradual realization that we will never go back to the way things were can be much harder for some than for others. We must be respectful of the reality that not everyone is able to move on, which has become the phrase we use to describe those who have resolved or at least accepted their situation. Others cannot move on right now for a variety of reasons. For some, it is unanswered questions or the lack of resolution of their claim. For others, it is the ongoing impacts of serious injuries or the disruption to their lives and the loss of a sense of power or control over what has happened. We must be mindful all the time that there are those who feel the pain of loss and trauma more sharply than others, whose experience is not the same as our own. Sensitivity and empathy will help guide us through this fourth year as we commit to finding the answers to those questions, resolving the outstanding issues, and committing to learn the lessons of what has occurred. When I think back to the day and the weeks that followed February the 22nd, my spirits are always uplifted as I recall the way we came together as a city. Ordinary people became rescuers on our streets. Selfless acts of courage were repeated many times over that day and night. I'm not sure that we know all of the stories yet, but we know that some died heroes reaching out to save others. And then we had an outpouring of support to help those worst affected areas, from the west to the east, from the north to the south. Groups like the Student Volunteer Army and the Farmy Army joined forces with service groups and others. Nothing will ever compare with the sight of hundreds of students pouring down my street in Bexley. It made me feel so proud and continues to give me inspiration for the future. I recently met with the families of some of those who died 3 years ago to discuss a number of issues. I was impressed with their guiding principles, which are to be inclusive and to use their knowledge and experience for future good. Their overriding message that they asked me to share today is that we honour the people lost in the earthquake by learning lessons from what happened and using the rebuild as an opportunity to make Christchurch a better place and an example of a truly safe city. When someone dies in circumstances that might have been prevented, one of the only things that can create meaning from the loss is the knowledge that someone in the future has been saved from going through the pain of losing someone in such circumstances. It is the best way to honour those whose lives were lost. All of the international experience tells us that the third anniversary after a disaster can be a very hard time for some people. Let us take that as a challenge for us as a city to accept. Let us unite as we did after the earthquakes. For those of us who have been able to move on, let us reach out to those who are still struggling. For those who cannot move on right now, please do not be afraid to ask anyone for help. Let us not judge people for where they are or how they got there. However you are feeling right now, as the posters say, it's all right. We can get through this together. I believe that we can not only learn lessons from what occurred on that day, but also from what happened afterwards. We broke down all the barriers. People simply worked together to get things done. I believe that's one of the reasons why we have young people constantly reinventing the city centre, creating interesting and unexpected uses of space. People realised that they could do something, and so they did, and that is the spirit we must encourage. It is the sense of optimism and creativity that can be a legacy of our experience, making Christchurch not only a safe city, but one which enables each one of us to create the life we want to lead. We are at a turning point. Let us claim our future. Remembering our past,
honouring those whose lives were lost or changed forever, acknowledging the significance of Christchurch being the final resting place of many from overseas and what that means to their families, respecting all who make Christchurch their home, and creating for ourselves a sense of place where we all belong.
Can I simply acknowledge the comments made by Her Worship the Mayor and endorse them? It's my great privilege and duty to read now a message sent to the people of Christchurch by His Highness Prince William, Duke of Cambridge. It reads, 3 years ago today, the city of Christchurch and wider Canterbury suffered a devastating tragedy. Lives were lost and the heart of a city was ripped out. It seemed unbelievable that this beautiful and historic place could suffer such a crippling blow, with so many families and friendships irretrievably broken. When I visited Christchurch in March of 2011, I saw the destruction firsthand, and I had a chance to hear about the selfless heroism of first responders and ordinary men and women who reached out to their neighbours. Cantabrians' response on that fateful day and in the weeks following was testament to the human spirit at its very best. 3 years have now passed. For some of you who have suffered bereavements and shocks, the events of the 22nd of February 2011 will seem like yesterday. You will perhaps wonder how you've managed to carry on. Yet step by step, Christchurch is recovering and rebuilding. The city is beginning a new chapter in its history, and I'm greatly looking forward to returning to Christchurch to see some of the progress and to witness again the unquenchable spirit of this place. On this anniversary, please be assured that you are in the thoughts and prayers of countless people around the world, fellow Cantabrians, all of us. Catherine and I send you our warm wishes, and we hope that you find comfort as you gather with your friends, neighbours and loved ones to remember what was lost. William.
The act of remembrance will be read by the Reverend James Ulrich, Chaplain to the New Zealand Fire Service, and the Reverend Mary Giles, Chaplain to the Police Force.
With the stirring of the wind and in the chill of the winter, under the blue sky and in the warmth of summer, we remember them. With joys we long to share, and in sorrow we bear alone. In work we have to do, and with life we have to give, we remember them. In treasured memories of the past and during the days to come, we remember them.
In all that they achieved, and for all that might have been, at the dawn of the day and in the setting sun, we remember them. From all corners of the world, with all our creeds, with all our similarities and differences, we remember them.
Official wreaths will now be laid by government, parliamentarians, the city, first responders, and international organizations. The Honorable Jerry Brownlee, Minister of Canterbury Earthquake Recovery, on behalf of the government and people of New Zealand.
Thank you.
the Honourable Ruth Dyson, Member of Parliament for the Port Hills, on behalf of the Leader of the Opposition. Her Worship, the Honourable Leanne Dalzell, Mayor of Christchurch, on behalf of the Community of Christchurch. David Perenara O'Connell, Turunanga o Naitahu, on behalf of the Tangata Whenua. The Honourable Norio Mitsuya, Parliamentary Senior Vice Minister for Foreign Affairs of Japan, on behalf of the international community. Superintendent Gary Knowles, Canterbury District Police Commander, on behalf of the New Zealand Police. Area Commander Dave Stackhouse, on behalf of the New Zealand Fire Service. Graham Gillespie, Chairman of the Christchurch Area Committee of St. John, and Laura McConkie, Ambulance Communications, on behalf of St. John. Lieutenant Colonel Nathan Baker, on behalf of the New Zealand Defence Force. Sinclair, on behalf of Christchurch City Civil Defence and Emergency Management. Yvonne Morgan and Tony Payne, on behalf of New Zealand Red Cross. Major Robert Cope and Major Julie Cope, on behalf of the Salvation Army. The names of the 185 people who died as a result of the earthquake will now be read out. We will begin with the names of people from other countries, introducing their country of origin as we proceed. We will then read the names of New Zealand residents and citizens who lost their lives in alphabetical order.
From China, Cai Yu, Chen Yang, Han Xiling, He Wen, Huo Siwen, Jin Man, Lai Chang, Leng Jingyan, Li De, Li Wanju, Li Xia,
Fu Hui Yun,
Wang Li Min, Wang Tao, Xin Si Si, Xu Lin Lin, Xu Xiu Juan, Ye Cai Ying, Zhang Di Di, Zhang Hui, Zhang Wei Yu, Zhong Yan Tao, Zhou Xiao Li.
From Japan, Arai Marina, Hamazaki Yuki, Hasumoto Yuki, Hata Yumiko, Hayasaka Miki, Hirabayashi Yuko, Hirauchi Yoshiko, Horita Megumi, Hoshiba Hifumi, Hyakuman Haruki, Hyuga Rika, Imaoka Toshiko, Ishikuro Tomoki, Kanamaru Kayo,
Kawahata Kyoko, Kikuda Saori, Kitagawa Yasuhiro, Murakami Emi, Otsubo Noriko, Sakuda Saya, Sakurai Yoko, Suzuki Yoko, Tamano Hiroko, Tsuchihashi Asuka, Uchihira Yurika, Yamaguchi Ayako, Yamatan Mina, Yokota Saki.
From the Philippines, Lalaine Collado Agatep, Mary Louise Ann Bantillo Amatillo, Amabel Kabahog Anoba, Valkin Descalzota Bensurto, Ivy Jane Cabunilas, John Christopher Villegas Chua, Jewel Jose Francisco, Ezra May Sabayton Medalye, Erica Avir Reyes Nora, Jesse Lloyd Redoble, Rhea May Sumalpong.
From Australia, Kerry Stewart Bird. From Canada, Marielle Falado. From Ireland, John Joseph O'Connor. From Israel, Gabi Ingel, Ofer Levy, Ofer Binyamin Mizrahi. From Korea, Yu Gin Hwan, Yu Na On. From Malaysia, Jun Jin Hee. From Taiwan, Li Xin Hong. From Thailand, Tatnida Intara Rangun, Pimpon Liang Chua, Harutaya Luong Surapi Sagun, Wan Pen Pri Klang, Chitra Waitaya Tadapong, Siripan Wong Bun Ngam. From Turkey, Didam Yaman. From the United States of America, Rachel Elizabeth Conley.
From New Zealand, Dr. Maysoon Mahdi Abbas, Dr. Hassam Saba Alani, Jane Marie Alberts, Jaden Brayton Andrews Holland, Linda Isabel Arnold, Pamela Christina Barkle, Matthew Lyle Beaumont, Dr. Dominic Joseph Jared Bell, Heidi Julie Berg, Andrew James Llewellyn Bishop,
Nina Jane Bishop, Iris Botting, Pamela Marie Breen, Rhys Frank Brookbanks, Melanie Jane Brown, Henry Ross Bush, Ian Neville Cordwell, Cristiano Carrazzo Chandler, Helen Margaret Chambers, Susan Patricia Shooter,
Stephen Cochran, Philip Graham Reeve Copeard, Patrick John Coop, Donald Ashby Cowie, Andrew Christian Ross Craig, John Barry Craig, Estelle Marie Cullen, Tamara Svetanova, Betty Irene Dixon, Joanna Claire Didham,
Jennifer Ann Donaldson, Paul Clarence Dunlop, Diane Mary Falconer, Adam Stephen Fisher, Maureen Valerie Fletcher, Ian Faldesi, Samuel Reese Gibb, Jamie Robert McDowell Gilbert, Joanne May Giles, Baxter Warwick Gowland,
Elizabeth Jane Grant, Natasha Sarah Hadfield, Tamara Leah Harker, Jaden Harris, Marion Isabella McCurdy Hilbers, Christopher Grant Homan, Amanda Jane Hooper, Kyle Brandon Jack Midgley, Beverly Faye Kennedy, Lau Y Fong,
Norman Lee, Adrian Isabel Lindsay, Sean Lucas, Scott William Emerson Lucy, Catherine McNichol Lunny, Philip John McDonald, Matthew Stewart McGeekin, Owen Thomas McKenna, Teresa McLean, Donna Mary Manning,
Kelly Lynn Maynard, Heather Marilyn Meadows, Janet Dawn Muller, Adrian Meredith, Kelsey Sunita Moore, Gillian Leslie Murphy, Melissa Ann Neal, Blair James O'Connor, Linda Rosemary Parker, Joseph Teo Pohio, Tanisha Gail Rose Prattley, Deborah Ann Roberts, Joseph Stewart Rutledge, Lucy Rutledge, Jeff Palasar Samt, Gillian Sayers, Susan Lynn Selway, Emma Shaharuddin, Elizabeth Sinclair, Alan Alexander Sinclair,
Christopher Patrick Smith, Christine Patricia Stevenson, Rita Stewart, Beverly May Stick, Earl Nicholas Stick, Michael Stewart Coulter Stiant, Neil Glynn Stoker, Titaiki Tai Rakina, Brian Warrington Taylor, Desley Ann Thompson,
Isaac James Thompson, Leslie Jane Thompson, Gregory James Tobin, Shane Robert Tomlin, Elsa Torres de Frood, Amanda Jane Uriel, Valerie Volnoff, Graham Weald, Joan Dorothy Weald, Lisa Patricia Willems,
Murray John Wood, Julie Catherine Wong, Stephen Robert Wright, Owen Morris Wright, Paul Kai Soon Wu,
thank you.
from every corner of the world and from our own nation, we call to mind those we knew and loved whose lives were cut short. So in a minute's silence, we remember them. Pipe Sergeant Ray Harper from McAlpine's North Canterbury Pipe Band will play the lament, Flowers of the Forest.
Kia whakapāingi a koutou e te atua kaha rawa, e te matua, e te tamaiti, e te wairua tapu. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let The service is ended now. May we depart in peace. If you have a floral tribute with you, you can cast it into the river at the woodland footbridge by the Peace Bell to be part of the river of flowers. Please, however tempting it is, don't pick the flowers in the botanic gardens. If your tribute has cellophane or any other non-organic material, you're very welcome to lay it at the foot of the Memorial of Remembrance. Thank you all very much indeed.